Greetings, welcome back to some more Long War 2. We have our second troop column mission of the campaign. Well, technically the third, because the very first mission is the troop column.
The squad is concealed.
Anyway, we are once again in a slums-like area, which I kinda like. I usually have a good time with slums maps. Would certainly prefer some high ground of high cover, but that's not the end of the world here. How do we want to start this one off?
Say again?
Let's bring you up here. We see absolutely nothing, okay. I mean, this building looks excellent as a base of operations kind of thing, because there's no other high ground anywhere around, so we can fight from the building towards the low ground. Only downside, we only have high low cover here ourselves, but we can work around that.
That's affirmative.
Some civilians over there. I don't want to get revealed by some weird patrol or something.
Closing on target position now. Got a group of hostiles over here.
Ooh. Wow. Wow. Okay, I mean that's the game trying to tell me something.
On my way.
Okay, so enemy activity is I think 16 to 18. So light medium, I think is that's what they call it. Concerned about all those mechs. I'm pretty sure I did bring some kind of tell me you have the blue screens. You do have blue screens, so at least that's something. But obviously this is not feasible, right? We cannot just sit on the high ground with four people and then just say, yeah.
Roger that.
Bring it on. Because they will bring it on and bring it down on us, and then I mean it's basically either we move to the low ground or we get moved there.
In my sight.
What?
That's a lot of HP and not a lot that we can burn. So, that's a group of six, and that's a group of, pretty sure I saw four there. So that's 10 enemies. I think I heard some snaky slivering sounds from this side, so
let's get moving.
Just get a look in that direction. Snake and drone, okay. That makes it, I don't know. Are you guys free or is there another one? Like my plans for a flamethrower ambush are rapidly diminishing. Also my enthusiasm for this particular building with all the enemies just around it also not so great anymore. And again, this building really blows. I don't think I have too much of a choice. That one would be nice because you have like this spotlight here, which is a full cover spot, but then again, there's no way we can get there, so let's forget about that.
Sure.
So, hypothetically speaking... who can we take to the low ground here?
Heading out.
Let's come in here.
I'm still here.
Probably want to bring you back a bit. Still super clumped. Okay, there's still one more group out there, so doing anything fancy like moving Helena on her own to that side to get some flank sniper shots, that just won't work.
Push forward.
Question, what are my hack chances? We can shut down... pretty good chance to shut down one of the arches. Approaches to fight that kind of stuff.
Moving to designated coordinates.
So here's the thing. I can... well, I feel like I can probably take down a lot of that stuff. Like a plasma grenade, 4 to 8, let me just check here. A rocket, 4 to 9. That brings all of these mech into one-shot territory. From pretty much anyone here. And I could even like rocket and then grenade, but then again I don't get any of the mech corpses. So let's think here. Let's say I hit the rocket and everybody is in one shot territory. Well, there's an Archon. Okay. Then... I could also just... what's my damage on the Archon? Precision shot, I have 100% to crit. So that's like, let's say 15-ish damage, 20 together with a rocket. I could also, okay, activate. And then drop a flame grenade on the Archon. Someone takes down the snake. And we just take care of all the mechs. Feel like it would probably be a waste to not take one of the mechs out of the picture with a shutdown Trojan thing. Wait a second. So, I was showing me 92, but there's always a bit of a variance, which should depend on the individual target. So I don't think I'll have... No, so that's more like it. Could have probably gone for the 79, but that's... not a big deal. Head of a snake, eh? Now watch the drone come suddenly across the roof here. Okay, everyone else just...
ready for action.
I was even considering, like, grenading them. They most likely all go on Overwatch. And then I could just Reaper in there. Well, once I clear the Overwatch, that is. Let's try to keep an eye on that other group in the back. Oh, they're coming on the roof? Got to be shitting me.
Alright, let's get this over with already.
Howdy! I don't think you...
Damn it!
Okay. Well, that happened. I have no idea where that last group is, okay. So... yeah, well, crap. Especially this serpent is suddenly a big problem. Is that not really highlighting that one archer there? Don't know, don't care.
Did you miss me?
I guess I just don't see the snake anymore here. So, question. -37 to crit. What? What was I looking at before? I don't even know. So he's gonna get stunned. He might be... oh, I was because of precision shot, I guess. Okay, that's pretty much a one-shot. That's my regular damage here. No, that's not good enough. Let's just take the precision shot against the longbow. Death from above. I'll think about what I want to do with that. Oh, you see that longbow? For some inexplicable reason, that's actually really good. Okay, I could have used Get Some or something. Pretty sure I will need to incendiary grenade here. And that's not even guaranteed to set the Archon on fire. I'm just considering if I want to do anything else this turn. Like, pop a flashbang. No, I don't think Getsum is necessary. Let me just check here. So Daniel can pop that guy, min damage is enough. Pop that guy. We need one more than min damage for that one. Because he has 10 and 1 armor. No, hang on. Coil weapons ignore 1 armor, right? I'm pretty sure they do.
That's what we're looking for.
Do I want to move? I don't think so. Okay. For a second I thought he would take down the floor here. Okay, so then we flame bomb this guy. Burning. So, there's a snake somewhere down here, which for some weird reason, probably because of that shelf here, I don't see it anymore. So I'm thinking that Sean probably needs to go down there and take care of it. And I don't like moving to that position. Because of that other group that we were seeing from over there. Maybe this will do the trick?
Just like old.
I should have just scouted the position of Caper. You have Shadow Step, so I can't overwatch you. I need to take a regular shot here and hopefully get the kill. Not quite. So what now? 45 up. Don't think I can smoke top and bottom, but I kinda wanna get a smoke that hits down below, if that's in any way possible. Seems to do the trick.
On my way.
A magical smoke spot. You're in defensive smoke. You're in defensive smoke. Just not sure what I want to do here with my second, with my implacable move. I think I kind of want to stand there, just... So if they shoot at a flank target, I'd rather shoot at him with 2 points of armor and 14 health than on Helena here. Now,
good copy. Moving on target.
It seems that our group either buggered off in that direction or is on the way back and now here. Either way, it looks okay. So that serpent is gonna do something which I don't like. But yeah. Get away with that storm. I mean, even down here, we have 40 defense from smoke and fortify. So I hope it's not that bad. Yeah, how about you get Trojan, my virtual friend. which should also stun you, right? Okay. Okay, disorient is obviously not something I wanted.
Under heavy fire here.
27, 37.
We have met the enemy in combat.
You're on fire.
Oh, oh, oh.
Cheating bastard. Okay, I guess doesn't care too much about the fire, I guess. That disorientation, that's gonna suck. Well, I mean 83. But I can't rapid fire because I'm disoriented. So, how are we gonna do this one? I mean, I got a magical smoke grenade that hit people on the low ground. Can I get a magical flashbang? Absolutely. Okay, so let's do just that. Give me some rapid deployment. Flashbang. Can I get it to hit something else? Low ground and high ground. I should probably take what I can get here, right?
Grenade!
Oh, also got the Archon, okay. That's a good start. So, what's the plan here? Boomer, where can you go? Oh, you're already selected. Oh, because you're the wrong Boomer. Cypher. I don't want to roust, I probably want to flamethrower these two snakes. Well, why move at all, right? Okay, I mean, there's a good one good point for moving. I'm kind of flanked here. One good point against moving. Will I get that shot if I move one tile further up? So let's have a quick rundown. I probably want to firebomb the Lancer. Daniel. Probably two shots against the Archon. Sniper shot against drone. And Carbon should be able to finish off the mech. Would have preferred some high ground again, but that position in there is preventing it. Then again, this is okay. There's no chance that this actually kills the drone. None whatsoever. A 58 against the Archon is kind of terrible. Well, if I get a crit against the drone, could work. Thank you. Maybe focus fire would have done more to reduce 1 point of armor. Okay. And if that all works, well, there's no guarantee that I get both of these snakes. I mean, that both of them actually burn and can't do anything. But I'm still in smoke and they are disoriented. I'd rather take the gamble on a low percentage shot from them than taking the gamble and not being able to hit them. If that makes any sense. That sucks. I might bring in Caper to finish off. Considering that. Okay, let's see the rest of the plan. Rest of the crisis management here. Okay. Hang on. Where can you grapple? Do we get a penalty to hit from range? No. But we would free up that spot, and maybe Carbon can then come up here and get a better shot against that mech. Just want to make sure that I still have Lannis out of the drone. Yeah. Oop. Oh, I'm no longer in smoke. Yeah, that's that. Really now? Get in range to use my double barrel shotgun against the Archon, I think. Okay, I mean, at least this part worked, so I can get up here. I can see the Archer.
About damn time.
'78, still not glorious. I could go into Overwatch, which might then also take down the drone, or maybe even help with the Archon if it's still alive. Let's keep that in mind. That's a nice crit, that's exactly what we needed. Come on, kill it.
Taken care of.
Taken care of, indeed.
Awesome.
On my way.
Okay. And we can do that. Set you on fire. I think I'm going for the Overwatch here. And over here, I'm gonna go for the casual slice from the back.
I'm busted.
Well, how about that?
back out, I think, to here. Let's just stay in the back. I mean, we have mobility, we can reach any point on the map, kind of. Now, the only thing that could go wrong is that Lancer and drone eating my Overwatch, and then I don't have a shot at the Arkham. You have in mind here. Okay, next problem. I'm here for the loot, right? So who's the volunteer to pick that stuff up? It's a bit risky. Feels a bit greedy.
Follow me. Oh yeah, lovely.
Okay, lovely indeed. Okay, so someone at this point, I'm kind of confident that we can just like pick that up.
Whatever you say.
Like, if that didn't trigger anything, that also shouldn't trigger anything.
I've got it.
Do I just want to run out here and kill him? Okay. This is fine.
No problem, boss. In my sights.
Watch you. Free reloads.
Full auto. You don't have to tell me twice.
Watch you. You can come back into the building. Oh, you know what? So much fire here. Let's come down here.
Back in action. Roger, tracking. Got it covered.
I mean, I was kinda exactly like I envisioned that encounter to go. Yeah, that doesn't look good. There's not gonna be much left of this building in a turn or two. That felt like an activation. Don't like the angle here. Probably want to drop a plasma grenade somewhere where it might blow up the car and might blow up that cover. I might be able to follow up with Reaper, but that's kind of risky. Might, huh? Might makes right. Really now, come on. So I'm either highlighting the car or I'm highlighting the cover object there. Let's see what that can do. Slightly underwhelming. That doesn't even look like it's on fire. So here's the question. What's my damage like? 11 to 15. So... thinking here. I think if I go to this high cover, that should might be able to hit all of them with a roast. Now that could mean that they'll get out of range of my Reaper, which might just be the thing that saves me from doing something incredibly stupid. Like going in there for a Reaper.
Heading out.
No burn. No burn. And no burn. Okay. Impressive move there from their side. Yeah, okay, I can no longer reach them. Let's see what we can do about this trooper.
Super.
That sounded good. Okay, so then I guess we'll just take down this mech. Two shots. I was just thinking, okay, so I decreased his hack defense and I could control him? Nah. Probably not. I also can't reach the mech. I could shoot the mech here? No. Okay, let's just... do that.
On the prize. Affirmative.
So, two options. I can dash up here, have a flank on the trooper and an Overwatch shot when he moves. But that means I cannot aid Protocol Boomer down there. think I'd rather have a kill against the trooper, and I don't even know what the officer will do. In worst case, he marks and shoots Boomer. I mean, he can do the same thing, like if I aid protocol, he marks and shoots, and then the trooper also shoots against the marked target, so that's not helping at all. Let's just bring you around to that side. Well, you know, he could run. What? Remiss, and he crits Daniel. Okay, that must have, like, somehow... What? Kind of played in reverse or something? So he marked, then he moved. And then he shot. Ouch. But very rare miss. I mean, high ground, Overwatch shot. I guess you really need that elite hat trigger. Oh, and I think we probably want to move away from this. Soon.
Bedauerlich.
Well, I guess not that soon. HP, huh? Okay. That's a guaranteed kill. With, what's it called? Oh, disguise signals. I think that's concealment for me. So that could help me scout out the last enemies. Just need to clean off that last guy there. Just focus fire him. Then just check what kind of shot I have. 53, that's not too bad.
God damn it. I'm still here.
New in for 40. Someone needs to hit that.
Let's try that again. No problem, boss. I got nothing.
Not quite. So, what are we looking at? 51 now. First of all, gonna walk via the trooper.
He's down.
I'm gonna use some placable to kinda get away from the whole bunch here.
I'm on it, Commander.
Cause I don't wanna take another hit. And now what? Should have shot in a different order to have the last shot of Boomer, because she kind of had the best shot, and that would have been then 14, 15 better. Yeah. Okay, just gonna reload. Take that shot. Oh, maybe I should have overwatched. Just basic reload and a walk fire.
Hostile pacified.
Now, do I or do I not? I do.
I can handle that.
No whammy, no whammy.
What am I doing with this?
Okay. At this point, I think I'm just gonna fall back to my fancy building here, or what's left of it. You out on the road and scouting.
I'm a bad, bad man.
Sure. Yeah, ready.
And we had the med kit.
Position confirmed.
You have one. Get you up there.
Covering ground.
Get some healing onto the man. I also still have a battle scanner, but
I'm going.
That's gonna be too random. Just throw it somewhere.
Man by me.
I understand.
Hold still. Ready for action.
Yep.
Okay.
Locked and loaded.
I'm kind of tensey at the moment because that all went
ready to rock.
Kind of poorly. I mean, nobody's dead, right? And that one injury is not the end of the world. But I was hoping this would go somewhat smoother.
So, you're gonna bark all day?
Yeah, I'm just gonna quick enter here.
Got it, I'm reloading. Yes.
Sweeping.
Okay, in that direction.
We're gonna shoot something? What?
If that is the case, you know what? Let's
whatever you say.
Get you in here and let's throw that scanner. Jet Muton Serpents. In the bus, are you like, okay, everybody else is dead, let's leave, let's go to somewhere else.
Walk the walk.
Yeah, good luck getting line of sight on those guys.
We do things on my time, not yours.
Right. Don't even know what to say.
There's not much time. I'll go first.
I don't trust that car that ate so much fire and grenades and it's still not exploded. But it did, and I just missed it. Not sure. They're staying in there.
About damn time.
Okay, Muton, Centurion, and some snakes.
I understand.
Okay, is there no line of sight out the front window here? Because I'm not activating them at all. Do I trust that? No. So that puts us to 17. I think it's 16 to 19, so that should be everything.
I can handle that.
Don't think there can be a group of two. To me, that just means I can kind of move freely-ish.
Location confirmed.
Okay, ready for action.
Okay, so this thing here has some weird issues with some spaces that which you can't run along. Other than that,
copy.
I want to get you in there. That break in the window might have put them on yellow alert now. Something I did not consider. I'm not sure if I'm gonna have any shots. At least not with the current positioning of them. Okay, it didn't have any effect, that's good. So here's the plan that's currently forming in my head. I have Caper in a position where she can easily reach anything inside there. I probably want to move her even back a little bit so she gets more damage.
I'm going.
Based on distance. And I know I cannot slice these guys, right? But the two snakes, three slice targets. Now, I probably want to activate by moving Cypher in from the side. But I'm not sure if that's going to activate. So they're going to probably take cover relative to her, which should then give me some shots here from the flanks. And that's where Daniel and, well, Carbon come in.
Understood. Moving out.
We have some help from Boomer here.
Move, move, move!
Who can use Get Some to give everybody boost. And any stragglers may or may not be sniped from back here.
Don't start none, won't be none.
in my sights.
So that all activates. I don't think I can move somewhere where I don't activate. Well,
aye aye, Commander.
Seems good enough for now.
Come on, let's go. I got your back.
Okay, next turn is go turn.
Sweeping.
Trigger fingers all.
Conchenso.
I'm on it.
Let's do this.
Heading out.
Okay. Now, if this doesn't do anything, then I'm just about to change my plan here into a good old.
Who asked you?
This doesn't seem to activate. What? Guys, it's getting warm inside. No, it's not. What? I can't target them inside there. I mean, it kind of makes sense. If they can't see me, then I shouldn't be able to target them. The bus is also immune to flashbangs. Kind of. Okay, just double checking. And this doesn't activate. What? What kind of bus is that?
On Overwatch.
Ready for action.
Sure thing.
Overwatch. Aye, aye, point.
Okay, question. Answer. Let's activate in a different kind of way. And we're gonna do the very boring gonna shoot you.
We should attack.
Say what? Okay, there's something seriously broken with this bus. Okay, yeah, I can't get inside. What?
What is it?
You know what can get inside? My fire. So, maybe the enemies are just generally stuck here. And that's why they're acting so weird. Has to be a spot where I can flame some more than just the guy.
Let's keep it moving.
I'm not sure what to do here.
Overwatch.
Okay, so you're burning. Okay, you're poisoning. Well, this is gonna be a very interesting fight. And by very interesting, I mean, what the frickledy frack is even happening here?
Roger that. Shot failed to connect.
Support has arrived.
Okay. So, I mean, how do you kill that which has no line of sight? Maybe my flamethrower here sets the bus on fire and it blows up, and then we can actually have a fight here. Well, I mean, it's not really a fight I'm looking for, I just want to slaughter the rest.
You have my attention. Yeah.
Well. Making best out of the bad situation. I don't know, that trickled my funny bone how you went out the window there in the back. Okay, cool.
Watch and learn, kiddo.
Yeah, I'm learning so much right now.
Whatever you say.
Smash all the windows. Okay, I guess we're doing that. You're gonna overwatch, and there's not much we can do. I'm feeling cheated about my loot here right now. A little bit.
I'm still here.
I wonder if I can actually see the enemy from this spot. Like, what can I even do here? I don't have any grenades left, so I can't really blow up that thing. Let's check if I can get some kind of line of sight from that side of the truck. Bus, rather. Anything? No. So I need to hope that my fire does some permanent damage to the bus.
Sweeping. Big dog is off the leash.
Got your back.
Check.
On the same page.
I can like briefly see them while I'm moving, but then as soon as I'm standing still again, there's nothing.
Affirmative. Covering now. I got your back. We got something over here.
Yeah, no kidding. Okay, I think the fire is burning itself out without doing too much. Okay, so now what? Even interesting that it said, even the mod just says there's one active enemy, even though there are two snakes inside. I'm just... Okay, I'm gonna quick add turn one more time.
Got it covered.
In my
just to see if the fire completely stops, and if there's anything here we can do. Okay. At this point, I'm not gonna just evac out of here. Like, ooh, I can't kill the enemies, let's get out. There's clearly something wrong with this map plot. I also can't get on top of this bus. So I think I'm just gonna kill all AIs using the console here. Cheetah! No, seriously, but what else can we do? I don't think I can even teleport to cursor inside because I can't get a cursor position. And this obviously made the mission a little bit easier because four enemies didn't participate in the fight. At the same time, I didn't get the loot that they are carrying, blah blah blah. Either way, how is it even worth? I actually never used that command. Kill all AI. Can I add? No? I think I needed to... is that case sensitive? Let me just put my microphone to the side. That doesn't even work. Or does it? Let me just end the turn here.
Scanning. Ready for action.
Roger.
Okay, there we go. Weird. Just gonna leave it there. I'm pretty sure even if we still had a rocket or grenade or anything, it wouldn't have done anything to the bus, because that map plot was clearly broken. I mean, I've had this specific bus on other maps plenty of times. Like, there was a retaliation map where you have all the RVs and buses and everything, and you can run through that bus, like, get in on the one side, get out on the other one. It can blow up and then it's kind of weird cover, etc. But yeah, I don't know. Hey, you tell me what you think about that. Not even sure if we get the bodies from those enemies. I don't care. Promotions. We've got our very first sting grenades. Flashbang grenades now have a 50% chance to stun enemies for one turn in the F area of effect. So good. At this point, a flashbang suddenly becomes something you can open up with on a group because of the huge radius that flashbangs have. That's so good. That's such a good thing. Actually, chain shot would have also been nice with a high aim. Talking about skills that are just so good. Quick burn. So, yeah. That's similar to Fortify. You activate it. It has like a, what, 5 turn cooldown. And then your burning action doesn't cost an action. Which allows you to do fancy stuff like run to the enemy, quick burn, burn them all, and run back into cover. Or, you know, double burn, or rocket and... no, not rocket and burn, that's salvo. Burn and then rocket or whatever. And finally... right, full override is yet... is just now on this level here. So, normally threat assessment would perfectly fit into the whole Overwatch theme, right? And it kind of has its uses where you just, if you're in a good position, you threat assessment yourself and go into Overwatch, and then you have free Overwatch shots. That's amazing, right? That's good. No questions asked. But other than that, using it on others that are not Overwatch spec might not be that great. Often you just want to threat assessment someone who needs the 8 protocol, and it increases the cooldown on 8 protocol. Additionally, there's one weird interaction. So if you get threat assessment, or 8 protocol in that case, to someone, then they are technically on Overwatch, and the units that are on Overwatch cannot be commanded. So if you had planned to 8 protocol someone and then command them to run an enemy Overwatch shot or something like that, you can no longer do that, because suddenly your 8 protocol prevents that. That being said, I'm completely undecided. Now, full override is just amazing. You can just permanently control someone. So you have basically two hacking options, one to control an enemy mech for the rest of the mission, and then control the mech for the rest of the game. Which basically means if the mission ends, then the mech will make its way to the resistance base, and you have a resistance mech in that area. Which is super good. And then rescue protocol, I've never actually had this on anyone, but I think it's kind of useful. So one thing I'm not sure about with Rescue Protocol, is it like 8 protocol that you can use it on anyone just like that, or do you need to have line of sight? I actually am completely undecided. So for the first time, I think I'm gonna skip assigning a skill for now and just make up my mind between episodes. Anyway, 44 supplies, 10 crystals, 7 alloys, and a bunch of corpses. Especially mech corpses. I'm not even sure what we use them for, but yeah. So we got one Viper corpse. I guess, yeah, we burnt one Viper, so no corpse from that. And we slashed one, so the two Vipers in the bus at the end didn't even give corpses. Boo. Oh, now this one. This one is huge. Archon corpse. Archon autopsy means tier 3 swords. Then again, yeah, we need additional Archons to actually get the swords. One thing I wanted to check quickly, Boomer 96 aim. Yeah, I think I wanna get that lead by example. So I don't think we had any missions we were waiting for people for on thing. No. But maybe now. 2 days, 5 hours? Probably not. What's that? A jailbreak. With a 6-day timer. And 1, 2, 3 rebels. Interesting. Now it's in the region where we still have like 10, 11 rebels. 11. 6-day timer, very light.
Setting course for East Africa.
And we have one mission out there right now. In Europe. So let's do this. Yeah, Jane Kelly will go. I think we're gonna bring Chris for some scouting and slashing. Maybe in there. Becca. I wanna have some grenades, I think. I'm looking for. You're infiltrating. Where's like. Ah, blind. Oh, here's. Oh, Mike's wounded. Alright. Athena's infiltrating. Dana, we already have an officer. Well, we could swap that around, right? Let's bring Dana in as officer. And we're gonna get Cynthia, if she's available, as specialist. Yes. And that will have to be that. An elite trigger. Do you already have cool under pressure? No, so you can't crit, so no laser sight for you. Okay, that's cool. We have here elite, elite, advanced, that's good enough. I don't think I had a single elite scope so far in this campaign. Or elite stock for that matter. So, blue screens, right? I said I always want to have blue screen rounds on someone. And you have shredding. Do we have like a subcoiler? Not even sure whose subcoiler that is. Oh, yeah, Boomer. Okay, in case we need some shredding, we do have a good weapon of that. Still probably want a blue screen somewhere. Let's take it on the assault rifle. Now, here's a good question. Do we want a Mark II holotargeter? Well, that's what we need Mech Rex for. We use it that rarely, the holotargeting ability. It's probably not worth it. Speed, speed, body shield. Yeah, let's go. Get us some rebels. And let's
setting course for the South African sector.
Let's finish that relay. Or, you know, let's get another mission. You know what? I'm gonna pass on that one. It's a great... Do I pass on that one? It's an en- we really don't need an engineer. I mean, it's a great timer, so kind of at least opportunity to get some XP, but then again, it's a VIP extraction mission, so that means no concealment. Yeah, I skipped one. Here, on the other hand, we've got a smash and grab.
Setting course for the East African sector.
That needs to happen. So means we need some visibility there. Running out of people. Too many injured. So I guess we'll have to take from the top, and that means we have nobody available for any other mission that pops up. We could get our Haven advisors. That's Victor and Ross. So torn. Like, I feel like I'm not using my gunners enough, and I don't have enough leveled up gunners. At the same time, for smash and grab, depending on where the evac point and where the objectives are, gunners are often so slow. We're gonna try to make it work here. One more. Let's get you in there. Okay, double shinobi for scouting and just killing everybody with slice. You've got to fix that. Laser cannon, huh? Laser lance. I mean, don't we at least... Obviously, I don't want to build a mech cannon. Not when we are like a few days away from researching coil. Could swap you out for that long rifle from Helena. And while you're at it, also take the pistol? No. Not sure who has the mech pistol right now. Let's fix your torso. I think I'm gonna combat that whole movement problem by just not bringing any grenades. Getting some, I guess, needle rounds. Copper plating, good. And then we want some kind of hair trigger. Expanded mag and autoloader. So, I guess we can take that coil rifle, because Daniel is injured anyway. Not sure how much shooting we're gonna actually do. So, knowing the game, I'll probably find some really important missions any second now, and then I'll have to look around and see which mission I recall or boost or whatever. Now, interestingly enough, I know I was going to say everybody is down in strength, but no, it's still enough strength over here to get another troop column. I'm just not sure what the cooldown on them is. I don't think you can get them like back to back to back. Oh boy. As I was saying, really important mission. Yeah, that's something we probably want to do. Tickle upgrade defense, bonus defense, yeah, that sounds nasty. Okay, let's collect our Haven advisors. Yeah, even you. Who's that? Yeah, Kato, yeah, I remember you.
Setting course for Sector 12, East Africa.
I just saw a message in the corner of my screen that someone was available who was injured. I guess I have to make up my mind what kind of skill I want to take. Yeah, Roberta got back. Okay, so that's good. Victor, Ross. So what we don't have is a shinobi. What are we doing anyway? Neutralize target in a vehicle, okay. Can do that, I guess. I think we could bring maybe Beatrice as a technical. No, never mind, hang on, we've got Ross as technical. Like, do we want to bring anyone else? No, not really. The only problem is we don't have any equipment. No, would you look at that? Two predator armors. We only needed one. Get one more blue screen. That's gonna be awkward, but I guess you can still rock with a laser lens, right? You might be able to swing something here, like that's why I took the Talon rounds. Let's see if we can get some value out of Kubikiri. So over here we're gonna build one more coil rifle. And if kind of everybody is at the moment out there, like with all of my equipment and weapons, I'm gonna press the magical button that undoes all your work that you already did. Okay, let's switch in advanced scope, autoloader, suppressor. I don't think, like, no, hang on, we've got hit and run. I was going to say, until she gets hit and run, she's not taking that many shots, so I don't need an expanded mech. Scrap that. So this is now where the soul arc thrower spec starts to shine, because of the hit and run ability and basically, high mobility, you're gonna take flanks and get in two shots from the flank, or get your arc thrower thing there. It's kind of a candidate for an aim PCS, depending on the mobility. I think 86 aim with an advanced scope is good enough for now. So, what else do we have? Let's pop the super suppressor on there. Can we do anything for you? Probably want an autoloader rather than a suppressor. Did I upgrade this one to elite? No. Here we go, elite hair trigger. Elite laser sight would have been nice. I'm so torn, unbelievably torn. Let's go full override. Anything else we want to bring? I don't see any medkits. No, there's only one medkit. Let's probably bring a second one. Yeah, let's get a second medkit. Don't have any cover destruction. Well, unless you count a rocket as cover destruction, which probably you could say that that's what it does. Go. And this episode is
Sky Ranger deployed.
Okay. Are we done yet? So this one is at 82 at least. Nice. East Africa is really our main base of operations right now.
Setting course for South Africa.
And I mean, look at this. Game's like, okay, let's start a second row. Moving on. Mike is back. That one's at 100%. We could start it right away, and you know what, I'm just gonna finish this one. No, I'm not. Sergeant Shinobi, and it's liberation, and it's 6 days, 10 hours. Okay, excellent. So, that's the screen I wanted to go to. We've got Robin and Sam coming back in 2 hours. So, we're gonna wait for those two, do that other mission. Let's have a quick look. Who's here? Andy, Athena, Kim. Yeah. That could work, and then do the liberation too. Now, I'm not super keen on actually completing the liberation chain in East Africa. Like, it's not an important sector. There's two things that make that interesting. First of all, and second of all. And I lost my train of thought, so then I'm just gonna put a cut in here, and maybe I'll remember it next time I record. So, yeah, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.